First of all, thank you for doing this with me.
You're welcome. So, what do we do now?
Well, I wanted to talk about Spirited Away. You know how much I love that movie, right? And I wanted to do something more organic. I wanted to do something more out of script, you know, whatever comes to my head at the moment, whatever comes to my heart, I'll say it out loud, and that's gonna be the video.
I see. So, what do you want me to do?
Well, I wanted you to just talk to me about it, and hopefully, I'm gonna be able to express myself and be able to express myself naturally and how I feel about it. Because the truth is, my love, is I wrote pages and pages of notes about Spirited Away. And though I could make a very concrete script about it, it didn't feel right. It felt like it would be like everybody else's videos on YouTube. It felt like it would just be another scripted video talking about what's good about this movie on a technical level. So I wanted to do something different. I wanted it to come from the heart. So I just want you to talk to me like you always do. Ask me questions about the movie, like we always talk about stuff, and we'll see how that goes.
Okay. So, what, how did you come across that movie? Like, what made you think, oh, I want to watch that?
Well, it was nothing particularly ordinary. I mean, it wasn't anything particularly extraordinary, you know. It was the first Ghibli movie I've ever saw, and I had a friend come over to my house, and I was like, "Oh, I want to watch this. Do you want to watch it with me?" And since she was one of my few friends who didn't really discriminate against anime too much, she was like, "Yeah, sure, whatever." And then we did on my very old laptop. We watched it together. And it, at the time, it was the most magical and wonderful experience I've ever had. Everything about that movie oozed with creativity in a way that I have never seen before. And I still feel to this day as strongly for it as I felt back then. From the very beginning, from that very first track that Joe Hinashi made, One Summer's Day, you know him very well, right?
Yeah.
He's a very great composer. And from those very first piano tracks and, you know, that beautiful music and the shot of Chihiro being driven around the car, everything about it was just perfect. I was sucked in immediately.
So it was like at the very first moment you saw, like that was the first scene that made it already like wow, or
Exactly.
I see.
I was wild from the very beginning. And to this day, I feel like the more times I watch Spirited Away, the more emotional I get. You know, there's this one YouTuber who once did a critic for Spirited Away, and he said, "This movie is so perfect and so creative that I'm jealous of it." You know what I mean? I mean, who is your idol? Tolkien, right?
Yeah.
You look at his work and you look at The Lord of the Rings and everything that he did and you're mesmerized by it, right?
I mean, it's pretty impressive.
I mean, that's how I feel about Miyazaki's Spirited Away. I'm so mesmerized by that movie that I'm jealous. I'm jealous of it. I love that movie like, it's almost like a child, you know? It's like, obviously, I feel like this jealousy of, I want this to be mine and just mine alone sometimes. But at the same time, I want every single human being in the world to watch it. You know what I mean? It's like that kind of love that I feel for it. And every single moment that came after that very first scene, everything about Spirited Away just felt fantastical. Mm-hmm. Everything about it felt magical. I was sucked in from the very first moment, and I was in that world. I wasn't Chihiro in particular, but I was living everything that was happening. And I don't know, I was just sucking it in.
So, is there like a favorite scene or like one that captured your attention the most out of the like all the scenes in the movie?
The train scene.
Yeah, very famous.
The train scene. Fuck. Until this day, I read a little interview Miyazaki talked about that scene, and he said that he wanted to simulate something like everyday life, more or less, but in a very fantastical way, which was like the normality of just taking the metro every day. But he, to this day, I don't understand 100% why that scene resonates with me so much. But every time I watch it and every time I hear the Six Station track, I feel it. I feel everything about that scene. And I don't know, it's just so beautiful, the way that the train goes around the track, splashing in the water, reflecting in the water. It's a train that is traveling in sea. And that imagery to me, I don't know, it's just beautiful in a way that I never seen replicated. And it's beautiful in a way that I feel like I'll never see ever again. I feel like Spirited Away is just a movie that's so unique and so special that, you know, just how you feel like there will never be another Tolkien. To me, there will never be another Miyazaki, and there will never be another Spirited Away. There is just nothing like it. It's not a 10 out of 10 anime. It's an infinity out of 10 anime. Everything about it feels infinite. Everything about it feels like, a lot about the movie is deals with spirits, and it deals with death, and it deals with, you know, life after death. Not so much life after death, but like the spirit world. And, you know, that train scene. I saw this movie before my dad passed away, but every time I watched it after that, I thought of him. I kept thinking about, in my heart, I feel like this is what happens when you die. You get on the train, just like that, and you go. And you go to a station in a train that floats above water. And I don't know, I feel like, I also feel like that because a lot of the residents of the train are just people with no faces. They're just clouds, but they're not clouds like in the beginning of the movie. They're not like cloudy spirits, like no face. That you feel like those spirits were actually people and they're just going somewhere. You don't know where, but they're going somewhere that is another place, a place beyond.
I see. So this movie there's like a lot going on, right? Lots of characters, lots of crazy scenes. And I don't know, is there like something that you didn't like about the movie since you really loved the movie?
No.
Nothing.
No.
Everything is perfect.
Everything.
I see.
Everything about it is perfect. There is nothing wrong with that movie. And I don't care.
Or maybe even least favorite scene?
No.
You like the whole movie as a whole?
As a whole.
That's great.
I mean, you know how everybody is a critic on the internet, right? And everybody is going to shit on the things you care about. And everybody is going to have their opinions, which they're entitled to, right? Just like all of us, but I don't care. If anyone has anything negative to say about this movie, even if it's valid, even if they actually find something that's actual valid negative criticism, something that's actually not good about this movie, and it's valid, I don't care. This is the movie that I refuse to let. I refuse to acknowledge anything bad with it. I mean, obviously, I will respect any opinion, as I do. But I simply, like, I don't care if you actually find something wrong with this movie, because no matter what you do, no matter what you say, this movie for me is, was, always will be perfect. It always will be 10 out of 10 for me, because it's not just my favorite anime. It's not my favorite movie or animation. This is my favorite thing in the world. This is my favorite piece of art that I love more than anything in the world, and I, you know, it's funny, like, when I was younger, I used to suffer a lot, because as an artist that I am, I said, I wish I could come up with something this good. I wish I could make something this good. But I don't care about that anymore. I'm okay with Spirited Away being the best thing ever made. But maybe if I can just replicate a pinky of that, what that movie did, then I'll be happy. I'm just so glad that it exists. It really, I don't know, Miyazaki always made content that defined, like, live life to the fullest, and for me, even though there are other movies that are very, very more clear about it, this is the one that makes me feel alive the most. This is the one that inspires me the most to want to create something wonderful.
That's beautiful.
You're beautiful. I think I said everything that I wanted to say.
I think I asked everything I wanted to ask.
I think we can conclude it now. Thank you for doing this with me.
You're welcome.
I love you.
Love you too.